Can I have another warm hand, everybody, for the lovely Alice Denny! Woo! This one,
hello.
That's it. Hello. I'm new to this town again. I ought to introduce myself a bit, but haven't got time. One poem, I think it comes in around about 3 minutes. Everyone's having a really good time, so I'm going to put a stop to that. I'm from Brighton. Woo! This is a bit about me. It's at such times you realise that too few years remain in your short life to hear again all the records you once bought, or even those you thought you'd always ache to listen to once more. Now there's no room to store within your head the books you ought to read, much less revisit those you've read. For you no longer need the strain of extra information. There's too much thought already filling up your brain to saturation. Now there's no time or space to take each treasured photograph, to place it in an album or a frame, peruse each face in search of lost elusive names, chase memories, past pleasures, games of tears and broken hearts, or days of sunshine, snow and rain, to know that you cannot regain those years of hope and joy and laughter. Now there's no time to say the things you should have said. Those loved ones are long dead, despise you now for wrongs that in their eyes you've done and severed ties, and some have simply gone away. It's at such times you understand that you can never find the right words to express all the happiness and sadness that you've ever felt. Those myriad regrets for such distress you know you must have dealt to others so much weaker than yourself. It's at such times you know that you will never be the greatest poet on this earth alive. That you can only strive to show the world the one you are. Tell your story from the heart in your own way, and pray perhaps to touch the hearts of others through too, with things that you believe, such as they are. Be true to yourself and hope perhaps to leave some small mark behind you. It's understanding how it feels growing older on your own. Knowing now you'll never really find someone who tastes of tangerine and cinnamon, who smiles whenever you appear, whose eyes you fill as she fills yours, whose tears you still as if by some mere act of will. It's her applause you always listen for, crave so much more than anyone's, though hers the loudest anyway, of course. She'd be the first to say, how brave, well done. Even when you try to sing, be your number one fan. And know for sure, she would always be your everything.